The Apocrypha are a group of ancient books with uncertain authorship, whose contents overlap parts of the Christian and Hebrew Bibles. The term Apocrypha means secret, hidden, or non-canonical. Indeed, these books have been considered sacred with a more advanced teaching that would not normally be made available to the general public. The Apocrypha includes 15 books, most of which were influenced by the Jewish canon of the Old Testament. Today, Apocryphal books remain part of the Holy Bible in the Catholic and Eastern Orthodox churches, while other Christian traditions still value them for religious study. One of the Apocrypha books is the Wisdom of Solomon, in which wisdom is personified, such is the emphasis placed on that virtue. Written in ancient Greek, the Wisdom of Solomon is believed to have been composed not by the beloved King Solomon, but in tribute to him by a Jew from Alexandria, Egypt, centuries later. Today, we'll read a passage from the Wisdom of Solomon and find valuable lessons on how being righteous is obeying God's wisdom and laws, while skepticism, materialism, and idolatry would lead to one's moral downfall. The Wisdom of Solomon. Love righteousness, ye that be judges of the earth. Think of the Lord with a good heart, and in simplicity of heart seek him. For he will be found of them that tempt him not, and showeth himself unto such as do not distrust him. For forward thoughts separate from God and his power, when it is tried, reproveth the unwise. For into a malicious soul wisdom shall not enter, nor dwell in the body that is subject unto sin. For the Holy Spirit of discipline will flee deceit, and remove from thoughts that are without understanding, and will not abide when unrighteousness cometh in. For wisdom is a loving spirit, and will not acquit a blasphemer of his words. For God is witness of his reins, and a true beholder of his heart, and a hearer of his tongue. For the Spirit of the Lord filleth the world, and that which containeth all things hath knowledge of the voice. Therefore he that speaketh unrighteous things cannot be hid, neither shall vengeance, when it punisheth, pass by him. For inquisition shall be made into the counsels of the ungodly, and the sound of his words shall come unto the Lord for the manifestation of his wicked deeds. For the ear of jealousy heareth all things, and the noise of murmurings is not hidden. Therefore beware of murmuring, which is unprofitable, and refrain your tongue from backbiting, for there is no word so secret that shall go for nothing, and the mouth that belieth slayeth the soul. Seek not death in the error of your life, and pull not upon yourselves destruction with the works of your hands. For God made not death, neither hath he pleasure in the destruction of the living. For he created all things, that they might have their being, and the generations of the world were healthful, and there is no poison of destruction in them, nor the kingdom of death upon the earth. For righteousness is immortal. But ungodly men, with their works and words, called it to them. For when they thought to have it their friend, they consumed to no avail, and made a covenant with it, because they are worthy to take part with it. For the ungodly said, reasoning with themselves, but not correctly, our life is short and tedious, and in the death of a man there is no remedy, neither was there any man known to have returned from the grave. For we are born at all risk, and we shall be hereafter as though we had never been. For the breath in our nostrils is as smoke, and the little spark in the moving of our heart, which being extinguished, our body shall be turned into ashes, and our spirit shall vanish as the soft air. And our name shall be forgotten in time, and no man shall have our works in remembrance, and our life shall pass away as the trace of a cloud, and shall be dispersed as a mist that is driven away with the beams of the sun, and overcome with the heat thereof. For our time is a very shadow that passeth away, and after our end there is no returning, for it is fast sealed, so that no man cometh again. Come on, therefore, let us enjoy the good things that are present. Let us speedily use the worldly creations as in youth. Let us see if the righteous one's words be true, and let us prove what shall happen in the end of him. For if the just man be the son of God, he will help him and deliver him from the hand of his enemies. Let us examine him with spitefulness and torture, that we may know his meekness and prove his patience. Let us condemn him with the shameful death, for by his own saying he shall be respected. Such things they did imagine and were deceived, for their own wickedness hath blinded them. As for the mysteries of God, they knew them not, neither did they hope for the wages of righteousness, nor discern a reward for blameless souls. For God created man to be immortal, and made him to be an image of his own eternity. Nevertheless, through envy of the devil came death into the world, and they that do hold of his side do find it. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and there shall no torment touch them. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken for misery. And their going from us is taken to be utter destruction, but they are in peace. For though they be punished in the sight of men, yet is their hope full of immortality. And having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded, for God proved them and found them worthy for himself. As gold in the furnace hath, he tried them, and received them as a burnt offering. And in the time of their visitation they shall shine, and run to and fro like sparks among the stubble. They shall judge the nations, and have dominion over the people, and their Lord shall reign forever. They that put their trust in him shall understand the truth, and such who are faithful in love shall abide with him, for grace and mercy is to his saints, and he hath care for his elect. But the ungodly shall be punished according to their own imaginations, which have neglected the righteous and forsaken the Lord. For whoso despiseth wisdom and nurture, he is miserable, and their hope is vain, their labors unfruitful, and their works unprofitable. Their offspring is cursed, and blessed is the eunuch, which with his hands hath wrought no iniquity, nor imagined wicked things against God. For unto him shall be given this special gift of faith, and an inheritance in the temple of the Lord, more acceptable to his mind. Magnanimous viewers, it was a pleasure to have you with us for today's Words of Wisdom.